Hi, in this workshop, we are going to create the high quality hexa meshing for MN body in ICM CFD, and also we'll take care for the first layer height and the Y plus, and also the refined mesh in the wake region for the better capturing of the J coefficient. And you are well aware of this geometry, and we have provided the different type of the models. You can work them, and in this case I will only use the half model without legs. So here is the ICM CFD, and I have provided all the input files, which is the space claim file, and the output files, which are the different cases: coarse mesh, fine mesh, medium mesh, and also I have applied the Y plus 1 on the first cell height, Y plus 5 and Y plus 10 for the different studies. For example, if you want to carry out the mesh dependent study and the effect of the Y plus on your CFD results, like for example drag coefficient, so you can go for these cases. And also I will tell you how you can create these cases during this workshop. So first of all, I will copy this path, and I will set the working directory in the ICM CFD. So click on change working directory and paste the working directory here and click on OK. And now from the file menu, click on the import model and double click on the mnbody.sc.doc and then apply to import the geometry into the ICM CFD. And after the file has been imported, you can check the file, and we can see different surfaces, and also we have some default boundary types here are the part names. You can change them. So first of all, I will be displaying the points and hide the surfaces, and also delete the material point from here with the default name. And the first thing I will do is that I will create my own material name as a fluid and choose the two locations. Based on these two locations, this will create the material point or the volume point between these two locations. And after that, I will create the parts from surfaces. So right click on the parts and create part. The first one is the inlet, which is here, and then top, and then side, the side, and you can display them also in a solid view, and then hide them one by one. So it's the side, top, and the inlet, symmetry, and this is wrong here. So I will create a new part as a road name and put this boundary here, and this boundary will go to the a new name. And also try to cross these options, because in this way, if you cross the point, curve and the material point, they will not be selected during selection process. So only surfaces will be selected. And we have the road here, and this is the symmetry, and this one is the outlet. And you can see here that we should be careful about this material point, and should not be contained in any part name. It should be separate entity, otherwise we get some errors. So it should not be go into any surface or any curve or any other part name. It should be separate one. And now you can hide the outlet, road and symmetry. So remaining thing is the MN body itself. So I write down here name as a MN body. And then select all the boundaries here in this way. And now you can again display these all parts in this way. And now I will check them: inlet, outlet on the other side, road, side, symmetry, top, And also I will create the new parts for the points and the curves. So all points will go here. And this time I will check the option for surfaces and uncheck option for the points. And now click on this option. This will select all the visible and the invisible objects. And similarly go for the curves. And this time uncheck the option for curves and cross the points. And again use this option to select all the curves. And now save the file name as a. In the D folder, I don't want to overwrite the my existing files. So put the name as MLBody hexa meshing, let's say.